Welcome to the Tantanoola Cave. So our beautiful cave here was actually only discovered back in 1930. 16-year-old Boyce Lane was out hunting for rabbits with his pet ferret, and the ferrets actually chased a rabbit down a little crack right up in the top of the rocks up there, and it didn't come back again. So Boyce has actually gone home. He's grabbed his big brother and a torch. A pair of them have come back. They've wriggled down the crack in the rocks, discovered the Tantanoola Cave, and found their ferret. So they had a really good day all round. Now, they were so excited about the cave that they opened it up to the public 10 days after they found it. So as you can imagine, there wasn't a nice pretty door. The first visitors had to make their way right up to the top of the hill here. They then actually had to sit down and slide on a tarp through the original crack in the rocks, which was about that high. You then had to crawl into the cave itself on your hands and knees, then use ropes and ladders to get down into the bottom section, and ropes and ladders all the way back out again. On top of that, in 1930, all the women were in long dresses. So it would have been a very tricky entrance, I can tell you right now. So anyway, over time, the family did make the opening a bit bigger, above where the door is now, and the cave was really successful for the family right up until all of the occupational health and safety rules changed in 1980, and it was actually closed down as being unsafe. Now, I was talking about us being an active cave. What that means is we need it to rain outside, and we need that water to get down and get into the cave. That can actually take up to 6 months for that to happen. Everything that's hanging down from the ceiling is called a stalactite, and the kids all tell me the best way to remember that is the stalactites hold on tight to the ceiling. So that's how you can remember. And they absolutely do, they're not going anywhere. So the very first ones that come through are these guys over here. Can you see these really, really skinny ones? These really skinny ones are quite cool because, believe it or not, they're hollow. So the water runs down the middle of them and leaves a little calcite crystal shell. And being hollow, of course, we call them a straw because you can actually have a drink through one of them, which is pretty cool. Then what happens is that little hole will eventually, it blocks up and the water starts to come down the outside, and that's when we move into these beautiful stalactites. These are candle or pencil ones. And these are the ones we're sort of used to seeing when we talk about caves and things like that. Then we have these ones. These are gorgeous. These are some of my favourites. These ones are called curtains or shawls. These ones need a decent amount of rainfall, and the water will actually come over the edge of the shelves, as you can see here, and through holes in the rock like that. And that's what gives it that beautiful draping down effect.